just for the bees.
That super was, we just added last week. Yeah, whenever we've added supers, we've sprayed them down with some honeybee healthy sugar water just to get them started.
And your honey super looks like you got a lot going on in that too.
Yeah, both of them actually were, yeah. Probably won't see eggs, but are there eggs in that frame?
Loaded.
Really?
Loaded.
I can never see eggs.
All right, I'm gonna help you out.
Because I can't see eggs, but I suck.
Can you see it in that cell?
I can see a spider on the inside of my bed. That's kind of driving me nuts. There we go.
Oh my god, yeah!
Let me see.
Ah,
now they're fixing it.
All those cells are loaded with eggs.
Oh, wow. Okay.
All right, we like.
Oh,
which
yeah, now I'm seeing them all over the
place. They're everywhere.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, girl.
To see eggs, you got you. It's best if the sun is high
behind
in the sky,
you, right?
Behind
and down.
You, and you want to rotate your frame so you can get the sun to light up the back of the cell, the midrib of the frame.
Okay.
So that's really one of the key things that a lot of people miss.
I've tried to do that, but I can never seem to see them.
You'll never see them holding it up.
You have the shadow from the cells,
yeah. Exactly. Yeah. There she is, as a matter of fact.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Hey, girl. Good job. I love you.
She's a nice fat Italian. Where'd
yeah.
you get the queen?
Hudson Valley.
Okay. Why don't you hold this frame for me?
Sure. This is the first time I'm actually holding a frame without gloves, so.
Okay. Good. Just train your mind to say, hey, just because a bee's crawling on me,
yeah.
doesn't mean it's going to sting you.
I'm actually not afraid of the stinging.
All right, let's put her back in. All right. Well, you got to train your mind on that one, too.
I know.
Type on three on everything.
Just as good. In the old days, people didn't use the glue.
Gotcha.
So, if you got too much propolis or burr comb, you'd actually pull top bars off when you're trying to
pull. Ah, okay.
Which is a real pain.
Yeah, I glue them all with the type on, and then I switched from hand snailing them to using a pneumatic.
Oh, nice.
We're hoping to expand to about 20 hives next year,
nice.
So we're trying to streamline a little.
Hey, gotcha.
That's why we started using just the eco stain on the newer boxes because painting them got to be too much. Yeah. And these, yeah, that's really great.
Yeah, I'll pull one out and take a look at
it. And what do you think of the top entrances, the shims? No?
It makes it a pain to clean that stuff up.
Gotcha.
Too long.
We've been sort of adding a super and just keeping one shim in there just to give them an entrance to start using that one, kind of, and haven't had issues yet.
That's good.
But
be careful during the dearth period.
Oh no, then we'll take it off.
Yeah.
Oh, that looks great.
See that?
That's beautiful. It's not capped yet.
You want to taste it?
Come try it.
It's finished, right?
Shim.
Yeah.
Also,
I can eat that with that.
Right there with
you. Where'd that go?
Oh.
The queen was walking around in the grass in your bee yard.
Couldn't have come from this hive, right?
Not this queen, no.
And I think there's a cage in the garage. No kidding.
I'd have stepped right on that sucker, probably.
So that? I was gonna say, could that be a mating flight?
Let's put her in a cage and see what she looks like.
They haven't eaten at the plug, so we can just throw the screen back over it. Mated, maybe, or? I wonder if that's from this.
It could be from this.
Because this had the cap screen, yeah. Winter, we were using a shim for pollen patties and fondants.
That's fine.
So they had the hole in the front there.
Okay, so they got plenty of ventilation.
So yeah.
Good.
Yeah, and we use screen bottom boards and we don't put the bottoms in at all. This one, they haven't really drawn out anything there yet. Allowed.
Now, when you saw the queen cells, were they in the bottom box?
The top box.
Okay.
And the queen cells were in the top box, right? Or were they in the bottom? That was the frame that we replaced with the swarm one, so we put an empty one in there.
See, they're backfill, because there's no new brood coming on.
Right.
You're replacing the queen. You're backfill. That's for a lot of time.
To get it ready?
Well, it's just because that's easier that way. Nice frame of emerging brood. They'll clear it out when the queen's getting ready to lay. They'll see these nice patches of just open cells ready for egg.
Okay. Oh, there's a queen cup on there.
Where?
Right there.
Oh yeah, nothing there.
that's what got me hooked.
Yeah.
That exactly. Right there. The first time we went out with Rich Schuler,
yeah.
I saw two brand new bees come out of their cells.
Yeah.
And I was instantly hooked. That was
yeah.
It. Like little baby
that's
bees.
Cool. That's cool.
Seriously.
That's cool. That's such a girl. There's some more. Not
yeah.
Emerged. I'm not seeing any larvae at this stage.
Yeah, well, last week we had some older larvae, but
yeah.
Nothing much.
Yep. And did you guys say this one swarmed, you think?
No.
No.
So they're just making a new queen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We think something happened, or... should be hatching soon.
Yeah, once one's capped, 6, 7, 8, 9, it's about
7 days.
7 or 8 days, yeah.
And
some
we looked.
Should be emerged.
Well, we looked Saturday.
Right.
Saturday or
oh,
Sunday? No,
Friday.
Sunday.
Well, this one might be, well, she's
yeah,
not.
There's one.
Yeah.
This one being outside the hive ready to mate, they're not going to be outside the hive ready to mate. Could be 11 or 12.
I don't know where she'd be from. You had a spider on your shirt pocket there. Yeah.
Should we put that cage in here? No? Let them do their thing?
Yeah, they know what they're doing. They got queens. If we put the cage in here, we'd probably kill that queen anyway. They got all these cells.
So where could she possibly be from? Or could she just be from another hive completely somewhere else and came over here to mate with our drones, or...?
No, usually they'll fly, they mate in the air, it takes about 15 minutes and they're done.
Oh, really?
Then they go back to their hive.
Okay.
So
where did she come from?
I don't know. Why was she on the ground? That's not the place you would expect to see a queen.
Right.
They may have kicked her out.
Yeah.
Huh. From this hive, you mean?
If she had a bird, depends, they didn't like her.
Yeah, I don't know.
See, here's my thing. A queen crawling on the ground?
We don't want that queen anyway.
I wouldn't want that queen anyway. It'd be cool to take pictures of her.
Right.
It'd be cool to do stuff like that. But for me to split one of these good hives, and put a queen like that in it, I would never do that.
Gotcha.
So these girls will be okay then?
They should be. So when are you going to be looking for eggs?
Work our way to that.
About
still have cap
3 weeks, right?
Still have cap cells. We think they ought to emerge in the next 2 or 3 days. How long, you know how long it takes for a queen to be ready to do a mating flight?
It's about a week.
About a week. Yeah. Okay, her wings got to harden up. And then we were just at the state beekeepers meeting. David Tarpey, who studies queens, told us that from the time she mates and comes back, it takes about 6 days before the sperm gets into spermatheca directly so that she's ready to start laying. Something in her.
Next week. Not this coming week.
Well, we got 6 days plus 6 days. 12 days, you know,
that's
2 weeks
basically.
Okay, and then if you're not good at seeing eggs,
it's gonna take you another few days.
I would say add another week onto that because now you should see large larvae, and you should be able to look for eggs.
Okay,
but you know, I would say 3 weeks, just like you said.
So the population is gonna dwindle a little.
July 4th again, right?
So the population's going to dwindle a little over the next couple of weeks and then should...
No, there's still sealed brood that's emerging.
Okay.
So I think your population's going to stay tight.
Okay.
The queen, the entrance producer, I'm not a big fan of that.
Okay.
When there's honey coming in and when it's hot out. Okay?
So should
most
we pull that then? Or?
Most of the places up here are going to be coming into a dearth period in the future. When you get into the dearth period, when there's no nectar,
okay.
You want to reduce it back to some degree.
All right.
Okay?
Yeah, we put it on because we weren't sure, so we can pull that,
alarm, no
you know.
No but you
yeah.
see, you got backup here,
right.
yeah.
more so than the other hives.
Yeah.
We were just worried about their population going down without a queen, and them needing to come back.
But no one's going to want to rob them until the honey flow stops.
Gotcha, okay.
And they got a pretty good population.
Right.
So, yeah, you can see them scenting now. You might want to take a shot at that. They're releasing scent out of their nose.
Oh, they're telling them to come back?
Yeah.
Oh, wow, yeah.
You see their abdomen in the air. They open the last two segments of their abdomen. And they, right there, you see how that gland is exposed, and she's fanning her wings.
That's amazing.
And they're marched right in there. What's that, John?
I was going to say the queen.
They're so amazing.
It's probably not from this hive, because if this queen hashed out, she would have destroyed all those queens.
That's
so.
True.
Good point.
Which would be really unfortunate because she's not a queen we want.
Yeah.
I want one of those other ones.
So any thoughts on where she could be from?
She could be from another hive around here. Don't cross them.
One of the nukes that Nancy's got.
Yeah.
There's a woman
I think she's a
who's in
the
club just around the corner basically down there who's got housing for nukes for members of the invasion. And it's did you get our hives over there?
No, I've got to talk to him.
Did you guys have a rain here short before we got here?
So, yeah.
Last night,
this morning, it's...
Yesterday afternoon?
Yeah.
Maybe she was out on her maiden flight, got hung up in bad weather.
So what do we do with her? Do we release her?
Do you want to take a video